Indian classical dance forms combine movement and storytelling. Stories, characters, and emotions are told through hand gestures known as mudras. Traditional Indian sculpture also uses mudras as symbols. We can see many of these symbols in sculpture, as well as in the Indian dance form of Bharatnatyam that is thriving in Leeds today. Let's have a look at some of them, and you can try the hand gestures yourself. Namaste. I'm sure you all know this hand gesture. What does it mean? Namaste is used for greeting others politely in Indian culture. Now you try. Put your hands together like this. This is Namaste. Katakamukaha. This is Rama. He is a hero in the Hindu epic story, the Ramayana. When his wife Sita was taken by the evil demon Ravanna, he fought with his bow and arrow. Now you try. Press your first finger and thumb together at the tips and bend your third finger forward. This is Katakamukaha. Roll your four fingers in and give me a thumbs up. This is Shikara. Now take Katakamukaha in your right hand and Shikara in your left. Pull the bow tight and shoot the arrow. Pataka. This is Vishnu, the preserver of all. The hand gesture he holds is called Pataka and can be used to show a blessing. Now you try. Squash all four fingers together and tuck your thumb in. Hold Pataka in both hands and bless to the side, to the middle, and to the other side. Krishna. This is Krishna, one of the most loved Hindu gods. He plays a key role in the Hindu epic, the Mahabharata. Krishna is known for being a sweet and melodious flute player. Now you try. Remember Katakamukaha? Hold it in both hands and bring it to your shoulder. Now you can play the flute like Krishna. Now you can see that through ancient hand gestures, the Indian sculptures around temples, in shrines, and in homes are brought to life today. We can tell any story we like and convey the messages that the sculptures hold to audiences around the world using the language of dance and gesture. Mm-hmm.